Hey everyone, CyberMatt here. So a while back, Atari announced they were coming back to the console race and coming out with a new system called the Atari Box. And that was pretty much it. They didn't give a lot of information other than that it would be crowdfunded. Then today we actually got some more information through an email that was sent out. They talked a little bit about some of the specs, although it's still kind of vague. It's going to have an AMD customized processor with Radeon graphics technology. It'll run Linux with a customized, easy-to-use interface. And they also talk about how it's going to be able to give you streaming applications, social, internet browsing, music, and more. And I guess that's cool. I still would like to know specific specs on it. But let's kind of go into some specifics on this. First up, the crowdfunding problem. So this system is going to be crowdfunded, not on Kickstarter, but on Indiegogo. Now, the difference between Kickstarter and Indiegogo is on Kickstarter, you need to have a working prototype to actually launch your Kickstarter. On Indiegogo, you don't, which does kind of beg the question if they even have a working prototype for the system yet. We don't know. Maybe they'll show a video about it before the Indiegogo starts, but we just don't know. So that does kind of worry me a bit. Another thing is that, it doesn't exactly breed consumer confidence when you are not going in 100% on this console. They could have funded this console 100% and said, "We're back in the console business. It's Atari. We love gamers. This is all for you guys." But they didn't do that. And I understand that this is a risky move for them coming back into the console race, decades after they left. And it's a risk, and they don't want to, invest a ton of money only to have the system fail. And it's far easier to just say, "Hey, do you guys want this? Then give us money." So I can understand that aspect of it, but it still is a little odd. And that brings us to games, because in this email they did talk about a little about games. It says that there will be tons of classic Atari retro games preloaded. And they even talk about current titles from a range of studios, although they don't specify any. But they do say that they'll be talking titles very soon. So, first off, the Atari games. It's 2017. We've had various Atari anthology games available on numerous platforms over the years. Not to mention the Atari Flashback consoles. And I think the hardcore Atari fans that would buy this no matter what, they already have the systems and games. So I don't think that's a huge selling point. And they don't announce any games, any new games. And it does kind of have this confu it gives out this confusing message. Is this system competing with the PS4 and Xbox One? If it is it going to have multi-platform support? Are games like Call of Duty World War II, Assassin's Creed Origins, Battlefront 2, are those games going to, play on this system? Are the specs even going to be able to play them? We don't know. Is this just going to be a system that's just, kind of released in a vacuum? And have some, indie PC games on it and just get released through, Indiegogo and maybe through the Atari website. We don't know. So I think it would have been nice if they would have released more information than this. Now, the next thing is the most ridiculous part of this email, that their estimated price range for the system is $249 to $299. So to put that into perspective, you can get a PS4 and Xbox One for $249 or $299. And those systems already have a wide library of games available right now. So I don't understand what the thought of the system is. To me, it goes to, it really makes you wonder if they have any idea of the landscape that they'll be releasing this system in. I mean, the timing is really strange that we're in the middle of the PS4 and Xbox One's life cycle, possibly towards the end. Why it releases now, I don't know. I really don't know. It's just there just a lot of there's mixed messaging, and there's just a lot of unanswered questions about the system, and just releasing a price range for a system that we don't even know if they have a working prototype. We don't even know what games are going to be on the system. They haven't even announced any games. Seems, again, kind of odd. But what do you guys think? Definitely let me know down in the comments below. And as always, like the video, share it, and subscribe. Till next time.